And I have no idea why Jax voted against Ned, but I promise you that I will find out very soon.
Yeah, well, when you do, you want to fill me in? I mean, it just feels weird that you have a friend who backstabs your husband and then he stands around laughing about it.
Well, it's an interesting board meeting.
Aren't they all?
Yeah, your family certainly has an original style of doing business. It seems to be working for them. You ready?
I was
just
ready.
A minute. Mr. Jax.
Hello.
I owe you something for what you did to my son.
Wow. It's a pleasure to meet you, too.
Are you ever going to tell me why you did it?
Vote against Ned?
No, wear striped socks with your outfit, Jax.
I did?
You know what? Don't even try and make light of this. Tonight you betrayed one of my very best friends in the whole world, and you didn't even bother to tell me that you were going to do it.
I didn't want to put you on the spot. Besides, it was a business decision. There's no place for sentiment in the boardroom. Ned knows that. If you blink, you lose. Ned blinked.
How?
By allowing Edward to force the vote in the first place. See, Ned put his job on the line and counted on elements that he couldn't control to save it.
Like your friendship?
Like my confidence, which is something else entirely. Tell you the truth, I had a lot of faith in Ned. Till Sonny showed up.
Ah. Well, there you go. There it is. I mean, this is what I was afraid of. You went against Ned because of Sonny, right?
The way you looked out for Lily.
Driver where he dropped you off.
Why, you wasted the trip.
I'm not leaving.
Yeah, you are.
Hey, please.
What's she doing here?
I thought you might need her.
Take her home. Now.
No.
Now!
What Alan said to you was wrong, Sonny. Lily told me once that your happiness meant everything to her. Now he's using her to hurt you, and even worse, you're using her to hurt yourself. That's not what she wanted.
She wanted, Robin. She didn't get a life or a child or a chance at happiness. Because I killed her. That's it. Because of me, Robin.
You keep trying to say you killed her, but it's not true. Her father did. It's not your fault. He was trying to murder you.
There's a lot you don't understand.
Oh, I know that. Believe me, I go through every day looking around at things and I don't understand.
But there are some things I do get. You're one of them.
I trust you. You teach me. But you don't talk down to me or act like I can't take care of myself. Ellen went off about how terrible you are. But they're the ones who have no honor. Oh, they get whatever they want, however they can. But what they want is me. Living with them, going to school, pretending to be their son who's dead.
What'd they do to you after they left?
Nothing.
Bull.
They warned me about you. They try to protect me. Same old.
Yeah?
They think you're using me. How could I possibly have a friend?
Screw them.
That's what I said.
I'm never going to make you go back to their house. You can count on that.
I do. You and Robin. You guys are the best things in my life.
That's a scary thought. I mean, not the Robin part.
Get over here.
I'm sorry to frighten you.
I love you. You'll never forget that, right?
Yeah. You know what else happened tonight? Jason made me a legitimate businessman.
What?
I sold them all this stock in ELQ. Hell, I didn't want their money.
Yeah, because of Jason, I have a seat on the board. Thank you.
Whew, I bet the Quartermains love that.
As much as taxes. You should have seen the look on Edward's face.
His teeth nearly dropped when he saw Sonny walk in. I finally met someone he hates as much as me.
You guys are really proud of yourselves, aren't you?
Hey, any day you beat the Quartermains is a good day, right?
Damn straight.
You realize that if you went against Ned because of Sonny, that this whole entire thing is my fault.
That was a business decision, Brenda. The trouble with Sonny isn't that you used to love him. It's that he bought into ELQ to look legitimate.
Well, what's the harm in that? I mean, I hope you realize that the Quartermains are way more dishonest than Sonny ever was.
The kind of lies the Quartermains tell aren't actionable under the RICO statutes. Now, if the government ever decided to prosecute Sonny, they could confiscate everything he owns, including ELQ. Maybe just Sonny's shares. Or maybe the whole company. Either way, having a mobster on the board is bad business. Ned let it happen. That's why I voted him out.
So you didn't do this in any way for yourself? I mean, this wasn't some sort of power play.
That too.
Why don't you tell me what you're really after?
What do you think?
Winner takes all.
Only stakes worth playing for.
Right, and you never lose.
Never.
Because if you think you might, you just walk away.
Exactly. First rule of the game is to know when to leave the table.
What's the second?
Don't be afraid to risk it all if it's something that you really want.
I know what I want.
Fine. I was thinking the same thing.
Wait.
What?
Give me 20 minutes.
Brenda.
15. All right, 10. Give me 10 minutes.
I hear the ticking of the clock. I'm lying here, the room's pitch dark. I wonder where you are tonight. No answer on the telephone. And the night goes by so very slow. Oh, I hope that it won't end though. Alone. Tonight, but the secret is is still my